this crusade.
We would like to thank you and the committee for the opportunity to testify before you.
You can speak directly into the microphone. Thank you.
Before I begin, I would like to introduce the president of the PMRC, Pam Howard, and our treasurer, Sally Nevis. The Parish Music Resource Center was organized in May of this year by mothers of young children who were very concerned by the growing trend in music toward lyrics that are sexually explicit, excessively violent, or glorify the use of drugs and alcohol. Our primary purpose is to educate and inform parents about this alarming trend, as well as to ask the industry to exercise self-restraint.
I can always live it. I find your statement to be boorish.
Harder, faster!
Incredibly and insensitively insulting the people who were here previously, that you could manage to give the First Amendment to the Constitution of the United States a bad name, if I doubt that you have the slightest understanding of it.
Senator Gore's wife talks about bondage and oral sex at gunpoint on the CBS Evening News. People in high places work on a tax bill that is so ridiculous, the only way to sneak it through is to keep the public's mind on something else. Porn rock.
In our society or anywhere else in the world, I've had in my experience two encounters with a sort of censorship. My song Rocky Mountain High was banned from many radio stations as a drug-related song. This was obviously done by people who had never seen or been to the Rocky Mountains and also had never experienced the elation, the celebration of life, or the joy in living that one feels when he observes something as wondrous as the Perseid meteor shower. Obviously a clear case of misinterpretation.
So it's not really a wild leap of the imagination to jump to the conclusion that that's about something other than surgery or hospitals, and neither of which are mentioned in the song.
No, it's not a wild jump, and I think what I said at one point was that songs allow a person to put their own imagination, experiences, and dreams into the lyrics. People can interpret it in other ways. This girl is looking for certain messages and bombers, and she found it. Someone looking for surgical references would have found it as well.
I got this glint in my eye when I bought the phone, which keeps people like Dallas when they're asking, is he or isn't he serious about this? Most people in Dallas have never seen that glint. I mean, how can any grown man walk around with a 12-inch sword blade between his legs and take that seriously?